should be able to go through.
Step from here onto the bone at the end.
Doug is a participant in our study. He is also an engineer. He continues to actually work using some of the technologies that have been developed to help people with ALS. ALS is a neurodegenerative disease that kind of causes a slow loss of motor function throughout the body. He's still able to communicate using a brain-computer interface and also an eye-tracking system.
So Doug is one of our really cooperative patients. He helped us a lot in settling our system in his home.
My husband Doug here was already in, had been diagnosed with ALS. He's probably 2 years in here and he has lost a little bit of his arm function.
So this is BCI 2000. It's what we use to record EEG data. It's also what we use to present and modify our paradigms that we use. The reason that we flash these math problems up to Doug is so that we can activate the prefrontal regions of his brain. We're able to pick up on that with the EEG and FNIRs, and we link up the times where he's working hard on the math with flashes on the screen. So that's how we're able to tell which letter he's focusing on.
So particularly Doug is able to use his eye gaze system, eye tracker system, so that's perfectly the best way currently for ALS patients to communicate if they are able to use their eye gaze. But later on when they develop some problems with their eye gaze control, so these systems can be used for him. So because we want eventually to develop practical systems that actually practically the patients can use in their bedsides, so we want to understand the reason for these BCI fluctuations.
It's really about providing the kind of autonomy that people have come to expect with interconnected technologies to patients.
My lab focus has been on signal processing, mainly brain signal processing. I do work with other types of biosignal processing, and we are mainly focused on development of systems and algorithms for different types of patients with neurological impairments, including patients with ALS, Parkinson's disease, different types of patients.